The Church Growth and Giving Show, your resource for growing faithful communities. Brought to you by Vanco, helping tens of thousands of churches thrive for over 20 years. Join Jordan and Hannah as they share insights drawn from decades of church giving and engagement expertise.
Welcome to the Church Growth and Giving Show. Today we're talking about a topic that comes up constantly in our listener questions, QuickBooks for churches. Jordan, with so many accounting options out there, what makes QuickBooks worth discussing specifically for church contexts?
That's a great question to start with, Hannah. You know, QuickBooks dominates the accounting software market with nearly 67% market share, which is pretty remarkable. But churches often wonder if it's really designed to handle their unique financial needs.
Right, because church accounting isn't exactly the same as business accounting, is it?
Not at all. Churches operate on what's called fund accounting, which is quite different from typical business accounting. The good news is that QuickBooks can absolutely work for churches, but, and this is important, you need to select the right version and set it up correctly.
That makes sense. So, what are the main QuickBooks options churches should consider?
There are basically two paths, QuickBooks Online or QuickBooks Desktop. Each has its advantages. The online version is accessible from anywhere, which is great if you have multiple people handling finances. Desktop is typically limited to one user, but gives you more control over your data.
Are there specific features that make one better than the other for church?
Well, QuickBooks Online offers some cool AI tools for insights and reporting, plus it integrates better with other systems. About 83% of organizations view integration as a top priority. The desktop version has more advanced inventory management features. But honestly, most churches don't need that level of inventory tracking.
What about cost? I know many churches operate on pretty tight budgets.
That's an important consideration. QuickBooks Online is generally more affordable than the desktop version. But here's where it gets interesting. There's actually a QuickBooks Premier nonprofit edition that's designed specifically with organizations like churches in mind.
Oh, that sounds promising. What makes that version different?
It's set up for fund accounting right out of the box, which is huge for churches. It helps organize information for your Form 990 tax requirements and makes it easier to comply with nonprofit regulations. You can get it in both online and desktop versions.
That's really helpful. I'm curious about the pricing, though. Are there any special discounts for churches?
Churches can get discounted rates through TechSoup, which is an organization that provides technology for nonprofits. They offer significant savings on all the QuickBooks versions, which can make a big difference for church budgets.
So once a church chooses the right version, what's involved in setting it up properly? That seems like it could be, well, complicated.
It definitely can be. The first crucial step is setting up a church-specific chart of accounts. This is basically the organizational framework for all your financial transactions.
Like creating folders to organize your financial documents?
That's exactly right. Churches typically need five main account types: assets, liabilities, net assets, revenue, and expenses. Then you break those down into subcategories and assign account numbers to keep everything organized.
Can you give us an example of how that numbering might work?
Sure. Most churches use a system where 1,000 through 1999 represents assets, 2,000 through 2,999 for liabilities, and so on. So maybe account 1010 is your main checking account, 4,100 might be for tithes, and 5,200 could be utilities expenses. This organization makes reporting so much clearer.
That's fascinating. I imagine setting this up correctly from the beginning saves a lot of headaches later.
It definitely can. QuickBooks also has some really useful features for churches like classes and tags. These are super helpful for implementing fund accounting in QuickBooks, which wasn't originally designed for it.
What exactly do classes and tags do?
Think of them as labels that help you track money for different purposes. Classes are perfect for separating ministry departments or funds. Tags are customizable labels you can apply to transactions. So if you receive a donation for your building fund, you can tag it accordingly and easily track where that money goes.
That sounds really useful for restricted funds, you know, when donors give money for a specific purpose.
And that's so important for churches. Donors need to trust that their restricted gifts are being used properly. With classes and tags in QuickBooks, you can generate reports showing exactly where that building fund money went, or how your youth ministry budget was spent.
I'm still wondering, can QuickBooks handle both online and offline donations effectively?
Great question. Yes, it absolutely can. For offline donations like checks or cash collected during a service, you can manually enter those and assign them to the appropriate accounts. For online giving, QuickBooks can integrate with donor management systems to automatically record those contributions.
That integration piece seems really important.
It is. When QuickBooks integrates with your donor management system, it syncs donor information, centralizes data, reduces manual entry errors, and automates recurring transactions. This is huge for churches where volunteers might be handling the books.
What about generating those year-end giving statements that donors need for tax purposes?
QuickBooks makes that process much easier. You can quickly generate donor reports and tax receipts. Just set the type of donation you want to track and the timeline, and the system creates professional-looking reports and receipts that can be emailed directly to donors.
That would save so much time compared to manually creating all those statements.
Absolutely. And time is a precious resource, especially in churches where staff and volunteers are already wearing multiple hats.
What about payroll? Churches have some unique payroll situations, especially with clergy compensation.
That's another area where QuickBooks can really help. It offers features specifically for clergy housing allowances, which have special tax treatment. You can also manage multiple pay types, like stipends, salaries, and per diems, and the system will automatically calculate the appropriate taxes.
I've heard that clergy sometimes have different tax requirements than other employees. Can QuickBooks handle that?
QuickBooks allows you to exempt clergy from certain payroll taxes as needed. There's a specific process to set this up. You select the clergy from your employee list, edit their withholdings, and select the appropriate tax exemptions. The system then applies these correctly going forward.
That sounds much simpler than trying to calculate all that manually.
It really is. And direct deposit is another great feature. A recent survey showed that 76% of people have experienced issues with delayed paychecks. QuickBooks can deposit money directly into your staff's accounts, which increases employee satisfaction.
Okay, so QuickBooks has a lot of great features for churches. But what about the learning curve? Is it difficult to learn?
That's a valid concern. There is definitely a learning curve, but QuickBooks is designed to be fairly intuitive. Plus, there are tons of resources available specifically for churches trying to set up QuickBooks.
Like what kinds of resources?
There are great tutorial videos online specifically about setting up QuickBooks for churches. The article mentioned one particularly helpful video that walks through the entire setup process. Churches can also find help in online forms. And sometimes there are congregation members with QuickBooks experience who can volunteer to help.
That's a good point. Churches often have accountants or bookkeepers in their congregation who might be willing to help.
And that's another advantage of QuickBooks. Because it's so widely used, you're more likely to find volunteers who already know how to use it.
So we've talked about a lot of the benefits, but what about potential pitfalls? Are there common mistakes churches should avoid when using QuickBooks?
Oh, definitely. One of the biggest mistakes is not implementing proper internal controls. According to a Keller Owens report, 62% of churches stated that their accounting staff couldn't even identify the absence of needed controls. This is partly why fraud can be a problem in churches.
That's concerning. What kinds of internal controls are important?
Things like transaction reviews, access controls, and task division. No single person should have complete control over the finances. QuickBooks allows you to set different access levels for different users, which helps with this.
Are there other common mistakes to watch out for?
Data entry errors are a big one, even with automated systems. Regular reconciliation helps catch these. Another common mistake is failing to properly use fund accounting features, which can lead to disorganization and mistrust. Income revenue confusion is also common, which means recording amounts correctly, but in the wrong accounts.
How does QuickBooks compare to software designed specifically for churches?
That's an important question. There are several church management software options like ACS Technologies, Planning Center, and PowerChurch. Many of these include accounting features, but they're primarily designed for overall church management.
So would you recommend using QuickBooks or church-specific software?
It really depends on the church's specific needs. QuickBooks has the advantage of being widely used, so it's often easier to find people who know how to use it. But church management software might offer features that are more tailored to church operations.
What would be your recommendation for churches trying to decide?
I'd suggest churches consider both options carefully. QuickBooks is excellent for accounting, but it wasn't built specifically for churches and lacks some features congregations need to grow. Some of the other systems we mentioned earlier, like ACS or Planning Center, can be a lot easier than QuickBooks for most. Either way, you can enjoy compatibilities with church donation software, like Vanco's. We understand how important these connections are for streamlining work, which is why Vanco connects with more than 60 systems.
That makes a lot of sense, using the best tools for each specific job.
Exactly. And speaking of tools, we have some fantastic resources available for our listeners. We've put together a church finance kit that includes templates for committee agendas, budget planning, and financial statements. Over 2,000 churches have already downloaded these resources.
Yes, these templates can be incredibly helpful, whether you're using QuickBooks or another system. You can find them in our show notes, along with a complete QuickBooks guide for churches.
And as always, we'd love to hear from you. If you have questions about church accounting software or suggestions for future episodes, please reach out to us through our website or on social media.
This has been such an informative discussion, Jordan. I think it will really help churches make informed decisions about their accounting software.
I hope so. Financial management might not be the most exciting part of ministry, but it's absolutely foundational to sustainable church growth and effective stewardship.
Well said. Thank you for sharing your expertise with us today, and thank you to our listeners for tuning in to another episode of the Church Growth and Giving Show. We'll be back next week with more insights and practical tips for helping your church thrive. In the meantime, please subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest tips, resources, and more.